Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Harshita and in today's video, I'm going to be answering some assumptions slash expectations that you guys have about Jinder Global Law School. So without further ado, let's get to it. So let's start with some positive ones because why not? So the first one is nice campus, hostel, placements in abroad. So yes, definitely it has a nice campus. The campus is huge and it's beautiful. You can do so many things over there. You can sit and chill anywhere you want. It's huge. And the campus is surely very, very, very cool. About the hostels, I gave a detailed explanation about how the hostels look like. So check that out. But other than that, the hostels are very well built and the rooms are also very good. You have a lot of space to keep in all your stuff. And overall, I don't think people will have complaints about it. Placements in abroad. So Jindal has a lot of global connections and it offers a lot of programs that involve international experience. So we have semester exchanges, we have summer schools, and we also have double degree programs that involve the global presence. So it's amazing. However, I cannot vouch for the placements right now because I'm just going to my third year, so I do not have much experience about the placements. However, I've heard that they're very good and students do get placed in the top tier law firms. Meeting different kinds of people. Yes, you will meet so many different kinds of people over there. Students from all over the country come to Jindal and the experience is very diverse. You will get to interact with so many different people. Also, because of the number of people on campus, your probability of meeting different kinds of people increases a lot. The professors are very friendly and promote fun learning. Yes, the professors are very friendly, but it totally depends on the kind of professor you get. Some professors are very strict, whereas others are very friendly and do not tell you anything. So it mostly depends on which professor that you get and what kind of a teaching method that specific professor has. So similarly about the fun learning part, it depends on the professor, but on an average the classes are very interactive and fun. I heard there was this Wednesday nights for girls and Thursday night for boys. Well, there's no such individual thing, at least I've not heard of it, but Jindal does have a culture of a Thursday night where people go out and enjoy themselves. So there is a Thursday night culture, but there's no specific Wednesday night for girls and Thursday night for boys. It's the same for both. That Jindal will reopen soon. Yes, we hope so too. We all are craving to go to campus because of the amazing campus experience that we have, and I hope it opens soon. Getting into the Moot Court Society is very difficult. Yes, it is difficult because the seats in the Moot Court Society are very less, and students from all legal programs are eligible to apply in the Moot Court Society. So the number of applicants are huge, but the seats are very less. So that is one reason why it becomes difficult. The another reason is because it is very exhausting. The memo round in itself is very exhausting, and on top of that, we also have an oral round. So many people tend to get nervous during the orals and they lose on their ranks and their seats. So the Moot Court Society inductions are difficult. Too many drugs. Well, I haven't heard of any place where students don't do what they want to do. So it's not just specific to our campus. Also, it totally depends upon how much self-control do you have. If you do not want to do anything, you can just walk out and just say no. People will not force you to do something that you don't want to do. So I don't think that really matters if you are sure of yourself. Lot of global opportunities. Yes, like I said, Jindal offers so many international programs and opportunities. So because of that, there is bound to be a lot of global connections and global opportunities for us. Good placements and good contacts. Well, like I said, I cannot vouch for the placements yet, but about the contacts, you will meet so many different kinds of people and your networking surely increases. So because of all this, you do get in contact with so many different people. I was at campus for 21 days in 2018. Want to see what changed? Campus tour, please. Well, there is a lot of construction going on at campus and all of us are very excited to see what they've come up with. There are so many new changes. So I will surely do a campus tour and many, many more videos once I'm back at campus. So stay tuned. Tell us everything about Jindal. Well, I made a video explaining everything in detail about Jindal. So check that out. Most of the kids belong from rich households, hence tend to be snobs. In my 6 months at campus and 2 years in Jindal Global Law School, I don't think personally I've met any person who is a snob. But because of the fee, even though most of the students might be coming from rich households, Jindal provides scholarship opportunities and many people from different backgrounds also come to Jindal. It has a big party and drugs culture. Well, like I said, I'm gonna repeat it again. It totally depends on the kind of person you are. If you're a person who likes to party a lot, you will party anywhere you go. No one can stop you. So even though people at Jindal do go out and enjoy themselves a lot, No one is going to impose it on you. Expensive. Yes, Jindal is expensive. The fee is considerably more than what you might find in other law schools. But I think the opportunities that Jindal provide make it different from other law schools. And if you make the most out of the opportunities that Jindal gives you, I would say that it is mostly worth it. Larger opportunity to go abroad, I think. Yes, like I said, it has a lot of global connections. So you get a lot of chances to go abroad and study abroad. So it definitely increases your chances to go abroad. I want to ask that, did you get any scholarship at Jindal or did you apply for it? So Jindal either gives you scholarship based on your LSAT score or during the course of your study at Jindal. So I did not get any scholarship off my LSAT score, but I do have chances to apply for my scholarships during college life, so I'm gonna do that. Scholarships during the course of your study depend on your CGPA and your financial considerations, so both of them are taken cumulatively to decide whether you will get a scholarship or not. That it's not safe for girls, well, I'm gonna have to disagree with that, because inside of the campus there is no safety issue. There are security cameras all over the place, and there are also security guards, lady guards all over the campus, so I don't think anyone will face any safety issues inside the campus. However, people might be concerned about the surrounding areas outside of campus, whether it is safe for anyone to go out of the campus. So that can be a concern, but inside the campus there is no safety issue. Drug culture not strict at all in terms of going out and stuff. For going out, it totally depends on you and your parents. Jindal allows a student to go out only if the parents allow them to go out, at least till the third year. After that, you are free to go out. You do not have to ask permission from your parents. However, that is also bound by some time restrictions. You have to be inside the campus before a certain period of time, otherwise you won't be allowed. So it totally depends on you and your parents. Better opportunities for professional networking. Well, I don't think that Jindal will set anything apart in that area, because you can do professional networking even if you're from an NLU or from any other good private law college. So I don't think that you will get anything specifically better from Jindal in this aspect. Best placement opportunities, I cannot vouch for that right now, but I would still say that it totally depends on your grades, because people get placed in the best places through NLUs too. So you won't get something out of the world if your grades are not good. Top notch, yes, it is top notch. The facilities, the services are amazing. The hostel experience, the mess experience, the campus life experience, it's all like a 5-star experience, because you have access to so many facilities. There are didis and bhaiyas to help you clean the room, and there are laundry services. So I would agree that it's top notch. It gives you the best facilities and the best comfort. Extremely strict, but India's best. I wouldn't say it's extremely strict, but it is strict. It has a zero tolerance policy for certain activities, and if you're found doing that, you might be suspended or you might be expelled. So it is strict in terms of that. About India's best, well, it is the best private college in India, so that's that. A lot of spoiled brats, self-centered, closed-minded kids go there. Well, that's a little harsh. I'm not gonna say that, but there might be some people who are either of these. Very elitist, very expensive. It is very expensive, and it is elitist in terms of the services and the experiences that we get. World-class facilities, excellent global exposure. Well, like I said, the facilities are amazing. You will find everything on campus, so yes, the services are very good. And excellent global exposure, yes, like I said, it has a lot of global connections. Is JGLS expensive? Can a common be there? And NLU versus JGLS in all aspects? Yes, Jindal is expensive, but I wouldn't say it's too hard for anyone to adapt to it. If you get a hang of the people and the ambience that it has, you can easily get adapted to it, and it's not that difficult, so anyone can be there. And about the NLU versus JGLS comparison, I'm gonna do that in some other video in a detailed manner. That it is very crowded as compared to NLUs. Yes, it is crowded as compared to NLUs, because NLUs have only 150 to 200 seats in a batch, whereas Jindal has 500 plus seats, because most NLUs just have one single course that they offer, whereas Jindal has 3 to 4 courses that it's offering. So because of that, there are a lot of people that get admitted to Jindal, and the crowd is much more. How did you get into Jindal? I got into Jindal based on my LSAT score. So those were the expectations or assumptions about Jindal that I got. If you have any other, put it down in the comments. I'd love to say if it's true or not. And so that's about it for this video. If you guys have any questions, do let me know. I'd love to answer them. And if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to press the like button and do subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.